1809. It was the year Abraham Lincoln was born, the year Franz Joseph Haydn died, and the year the organization that would be the genesis of the Child and Family Agency came into being. The country was undergoing profound changes. The economy of the nation was transitioning from an agrarian society of manual labor to machine-based manufacturing. Villages were turning into towns, and towns into cities. Proceeds for the poor, originally garnered from village residents through taxes inspired by England's Elizabethan Poor Laws of 1601, were emerging as woefully insufficient and increasingly difficult to administer. Poor law taxes had worked well for the English villages of the 17th and 18th centuries, towns with little population growth, and for a while the model worked well for the small villages of the colonies. But not for long. A transitioning economy, disease, and continental warfare began to deprive children of their parents on a scale too great for the poor law system to support. Dependent youth became increasingly problematic. Apprenticeship had long been a reliable method of solving the problem of poor and orphaned minors, but with the Industrial Revolution, the market for apprentices was drying up. More and more families and children were in need of help. Change at this time was occurring not only in the workplace, but also in the home. Roles of Victorian family members were finding definition. The man, as pater familias, controlled family finances, enforced discipline, and had the final say in decisions relating to members of the family. The woman, as wife and mother, organized the household, supervised the upbringing of the children, and set the moral standard of the family. It was the women of the middle and upper classes, charged with setting the moral standard for their families, that came together because they could not tolerate just looking on and doing nothing. They felt compelled to help the poor and needy. They did so largely through establishing female benevolent societies. These societies emerged in most of the major towns in what was at the time the country's 16 states. Among them was the Female Benevolent Charitable Society of Hartford, the forerunner of what is today the Child and Family Agency of Southeastern Connecticut. Since 1809, the needs of the region have evolved, and Child and Family has kept pace. Later in the century, the crush of the Industrial Revolution put hundreds of Connecticut families in both financial and social crisis. The BP Learned Mission, a child and family agency founded in 1859, was there to help along the way. Waves of Italian and Irish immigrations forced far too many to vie for far too few jobs. Through economic depressions, through the human losses of wars of long ago, and today, through the losses from modern wars, including the conflicts in Iraq and Afghanistan, orphans and shattered families, past and present, have been aided by child and family agencies. Agencies that include the New London Day Nursery, founded in 1906, and more recently the Child Guidance Clinic, founded in 1954. In fact, child and family agencies have all grown and adapted to carry on a 200-year tradition of being there for the child or family in need. Today, Child and Family Agency's mission is to promote the well-being and development of all children and their families, in particular to give priority to the unmet needs of children lacking physical, emotional, and intellectual care and nurturing. Child and family programs address prevention of child abuse, the treatment of family violence, teen pregnancy, parent education, child guidance, child care, children's health care, and children's mental health. Our staff of over 170 includes social workers, psychologists, psychiatrists, teachers, nurse practitioners, community workers, teachers' aides, physicians, administrative and support personnel. Individuals from the past and present have generously donated time, talent, and treasure. And today, members from Child and Family's 6 auxiliary chapters carry on the tradition. More than 600 members of the Child and Family Auxiliaries in East Lyme, Essex River Valley, Groton, Lyme Old Lyme, Mystic Noank Stonington, and New London Waterford have made and continue to make critically important contributions to Child and Family's ability to carry out its mission. While numbers begin to tell an important story about child and family's value, what tells the greatest story of all are the faces of those we serve. Dignity returned to a woman abused by her spouse. Children no longer hungry, laughing, playing, and being children. Young women dealing with tough decisions, but not alone.